Good evening. First tonight, we've been given a stark reminder that the war in Afghanistan is far from over. An experienced Special Forces soldier, described as an iconic feature in his regiment, shot dead. We don't know his name or his age, only that tonight his family and this country are mourning his loss. Ellie Southwood reports.
The news had filtered through to family overnight. And this morning, the Chief of Defence had the duty of telling us all.
At approximately 3 p.m. yesterday, our time, an Australian Special Forces soldier was killed in action by small arms fire during an insurgent engagement in Afghanistan.
It was a partnered operation with Afghan troops in the south of the country. In the firefight, another Special Forces soldier was shot and seriously injured. He's had surgery and has been able to call loved ones at home. An airman also received a minor wound. The fallen soldier was on his fifth tour of duty in Afghanistan, having already served in Iraq and East Timor.
His mates describe him as one of the most iconic figures in the regiment. In combat and as a team commander, he was the man to watch and never happier than when the situation demanded decisive action and courage.
The news reached home at almost the exact time as the unveiling of a memorial in Cairns for the 39 other soldiers killed in Afghanistan.
It seems particularly cruel that as that service was coming to an end, that we were starting to receive the first news of more death and more wounding in Afghanistan.
Our thoughts will be with the family today, but also with the families of the other 39. This will be a terrible reminder to them.
The bulk of Australia's forces in Afghanistan will come home at the end of the year when the Taran Kot base is closed. But it's likely we'll stay on well beyond that to train and mentor Afghanistan's own forces.
Each one of our fallen soldiers has made a difference. Their dedication to service and to our nation should be a great source of pride. I intend to see their work honoured and see our mission through to completion.
Ellie Southwood, 10 News.